हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ तुषार गुजराती फ्रॉम एसएनडी कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड रिसर्च सेंटर येवला। टुडे विल स्टडी टेम्परेचर सेंसर्स विच आर वेरी यूजफुल इन मेनी एप्लीकेशंस। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद दिस। सो फॉर सेंसिंग ऑफ टेम्परेचर देर आर डिफरेंट मेथड्स आर अवेलेबल। फर्स्ट वन इज थर्मल एक्सपांशन मेथड, सेकेंड मेथडोलॉजी इज इलेक्ट्रिकल मेथड्स, एंड लास्ट वन इज रेडिएशन मेथड्स। So like this, these three are very important methods for measurement of temperature. So electrical methods of temperature measurement, this we'll study first of all. So RTD, RTD is resistance temperature detector, thermocouples and thermistors. So these are three electrical methods of temperature measurement. So what is thermocouple? Thermocouple is widely used in industry. So the contact between two dissimilar metal alloys is a function of temperature. So thermocouple is prepared with the help of two dissimilar metal wires, and here as temperature increases, the output voltage increases. So EMF is generated here, output voltage is generated as a function of temperature. So here laws of thermoelectric thermometry is used. So thermoelectric principle is used here. So here Seebeck effect we'll study. What is Seebeck effect? If two dissimilar metal wires are joined together at each end to form junction with different temperature exists between two ends, results in thermoelectric EMF. Okay. So what is the meaning of this? So two dissimilar metal wires are joined together. So here one copper and one constant iron. So these two dissimilar metal wires are joined together at each end to form junction. So here T1 is one junction and T2 is different junction. If both the temperatures are different, so these are different temperatures, T2 is greater than T1. So what happens between two end results in thermoelectric EMF? So what happens? Voltage is generated between T1 and D2. Between T1 and D2, voltage is generated. So this is Seebeck effect, okay? Now similarly, what is Peltier effect? So whenever EMF is set up across a junction of two dissimilar metals, generation of heat takes place at two junctions. So this is the reverse principle. So when two dissimilar metals are connected and if voltage is applied, okay, because of this voltage, the heat takes place, means one junction gets heated and one junction gets cooled. So T2 gets hot and T1 gets cooled. So this is reverse of first principle, okay. Now this is Thomson effect. So here whenever junctions of two dissimilar metals are kept at a different temperatures, current flows from cold junction to hot junction. This is also same concept. So when these two junctions are kept at different temperatures, what happens? Current flows in this circuit from cold to hot junction. This is the Thomson effect. Thermocouple construction, which is not in syllabus, that we'll study. Homogeneous wires to avoid temperature gradient along them. So here homogeneous wires are used for avoiding temperature gradient along them. So junctions are provided with the help of silver soldering, brazing or welding. So junction is protected from contamination. Insulation between sheath and thermocouple wires. Industrial thermocouples have only hot junctions, and cold or reference junction should be constant. Okay, so this is some industrial thermocouple related points are shown here. So industrial thermocouples have only one junction and other junction is kept constant. Okay, insulation is provided, protected from contamination, junctions are welded, brazed. So these are all important things for industrial thermocouples. So like this construction is there. So these two are thermocouple wires, okay. They are protected with inconel sheath. So inconel sheath is provided on outer side, and inside that magnesium oxide is placed, okay. So like this thermocouple is prepared. Now this thermocouple has another outer elements are also there. like cover is there, terminals are provided, cover, terminals, enclosure is there, then terminal block, then mounting bracket, insulation tube, and below that there is thermocouple wires, and this last one is our hot junction, which is to be measured, and it is provided with rubber seal. So this is the construction of thermocouples. This is the actual thermocouple that we can see. This we can get from market. Okay, this is called as thermocouple. What are characteristics of thermocouple? If you see, so on x-axis temperature is shown, and on y-axis EMF is shown, voltage. Okay, so depending upon different materials, pair of materials. Okay, so the characteristics is different. So you can see the graphs are shown, linear graphs here. The material is chrome and constant ton, second material is iron and constant ton, third material is chromal aluminum, and fourth is copper constant ton. So these are very four famous thermocouple pairs are available. Okay, and most of them are linear. As temperature increases, voltage also increases. Okay, and some are non-linear or different materials are also used. Tungsten, rhodium, platinum, rhodium. So these are some materials are used. Okay, so there we get less sensitivity as compared to upper ones. Okay, so this is characteristics of thermocouple. Now temperature sensors are optical parameters are also there. Optical parameter comparison in brightness is used to measure temperature. So it compares brightness, and according to it measures temperature. Reference temperature is produced by a lamp. Okay, and brightness of the lamp can be adjusted. It is adjusted till its intensity becomes equal to brightness of a source object. This is the working of optical parameter. And after adjustment, current passed through reference temperature is measured. So we have to measure the current passing through the reference temperature. Okay, so if filament is dark, so it is cooler than temperature source. We can conclude that it is cooler than temperature source. And if filament is bright, it is hotter than temperature source. If filament disappears, equal brightness of filament and temperature source. So this is the conditions that we have to remember. When it is dark, then it is cooler. When it is bright, then it is hotter. And when it disappears, then the equal brightness is there. Okay, this is optical parameter. Diagram is also shown over here of optical parameter. So here one lamp is provided over here, reference temperature lamp. So this is temperature source, and here it is eyepiece. So there are some filters are used. Red filter is used here, and one absorption screen. We have to use here objective lens also, and everything is closed between this outer tube. Okay, so here multimeter, rheostat and battery is used for giving supply to this lamp. Okay, so like this is the construction of optical pyrometer. And we have seen the working. If we get dark or bright light, then we can say that whether it is cooler or hotter. Okay, so like this we can perform the working. So here you can see practical applications where we can use these optical parameters. Now we'll see infrared thermometers. So infrared thermometers are used for temperature measurement by thermal radiation from the target with thermometer gun. So temperature measurement by thermal radiation from the target with thermometer gun. This is the infrared thermometer. So here we use thermal radiations. So infrared energy is emitted by an object. So these infrared are converted into electrical signals. Remote distance temperature measurement can be done, which is not possible with RTD. So RTD, that is resistance temperature detector, which cannot measure remote distance. So that is possible with this infrared thermometer, used for moving object also. So moving object temperature can be detected. So this is the diagram. So here, hot object emits infrared beams. So through this lens and filter, infrared detector detects it and gives to it electronics, and thus we get output signal as temperature indicator. Okay, so this is the simple working of infrared thermometer. So this is infrared thermometer which we can see very easily in the market. So while this pandemic situation in the corona, so you might have seen this infrared thermometer in everywhere for measuring temperature of any person. Okay, it uses directly digital reading on